John. John Forshee. I think I've met most of you, but I teach music theory, computer music, composition, and a few other things here at UCCS. And it's my distinct pleasure, my singular pleasure, my unique pleasure to introduce Emiliano Gomez for his senior recital this fall. It's very exciting. I'd like to say just a few quick words. We have a good lineup tonight, so I don't want to talk too long as I like to do. But I'd like to say a few things about Emmy. The first time that we met, I might mention I've worked with Emmy for about a year and a half. And I recall one of our first meetings, Emmy approached composition with a thought experiment. He says, John, given that the farther into space, think Webb telescope, the farther into space we look, the farther back in time we look. Conceivably, we could look far enough back in time to the Big Bang with a powerful enough telescope. Or microscope, actually, to see the world in a grain of sand. You know, we can be a little poetic. And Amy put the notion that if we were to stand on any point of the Earth and look deeply enough into space from any point, would we not, all of us, see the Big Bang, or eventually our sight would converge onto one point? Would that be true? Would we be able to look back in time from any point on the Earth and see the beginning of our universe? And I think this is an apt metaphor for the music that Emmy composes, especially the music that you'll hear tonight. This is music of experiment. This is music of audition. This is music of dynamism. And I think most importantly for Emmy's music, if I may say so, this is music about relationships. Relationships between musicians, between performers, between instrumental sound covers, relationships across space, relationships throughout time, relationships that develop and nurture throughout time. Now you might think that Emmy only composes this really far out music, and he does compose some really far out music, but Emmy has also been extremely active in our community. He's composed for the theater works production. I recall one summer coming to a performance at the Heller House of
As You Like It.
And lo and behold, I heard Emmy sing a Renaissance-styled song that he accompanied himself. No, you had an accompanist, but it sounded just like what Shakespeare might have wanted. It was the most far-out experience to hear your voice, Emmy. Really beautiful voice, I might add. So there's a practical side to Emmy's work. There's a functional side. But I think overall, whether it's far-out cosmic exploration or music composed for dance, as he's done, or theater, as he's done, overall, this is music to be heard and felt. This is music to really be experienced firsthand. I doubt, as good as our recording is going to be tonight, that it will capture, you know, the real essence of this music. It's been a real pleasure working with you, Emmy, and experiencing his music and getting to know how he thinks about music. It's been challenging at times. I've learned a lot. I've been challenged, all in the very best way. And we have a couple of collaborations that we're going to feature tonight. And overall, this concert should be something we will never, ever forget. So with that, I would like to introduce Emmy Gomez, Emiliano Gomez.
So just before we get into, I don't want to talk too much, so I just want to make sure I thank everyone appropriately. First of all, thank you for coming to the show. Everyone's really busy right now. It takes a lot to be able to show up, I think. I also want to thank our performers for dedicating so much time to this performance. It's kind of a lot of work, and the people we have here today have been very responsible about showing up and caring about the work, which is nice. I especially would like to thank Connor Borgo and Juan Carlos Valdez, because they have come on within the last couple weeks, and it is a lot of pressure to try to do that. We were trying to look for numbers, since there's inconsistencies in any performance, I feel like, but they were able to pick up some work for it felt like it was lost. And I really appreciate you two for that. Especially Connor, just coming off of his own city recital. That's so much. You're great. You're all great, thank you. I also want to get thank John Forshee and Solveig Olsen for their help in organizing this recital. I took lessons with John Forshee in the last couple of semesters, but we're not technically working together this semester, so we didn't really have the responsibility to do it, so I appreciate so much all the help that you've been. I would also especially like to thank the professors here, Jane Riegler and Halle Agari, just for offering a lot of different insights in the last several years that really helped to expand my compositional practice, I guess. They're so good at bringing up new ideas that you would never have like considered in your lifetime before, I feel like, and then to get them so early is nice. And then finally, I would like to thank our work study students here, Julianne and Spencer, just for their help in documenting this work.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. While continuing your interactions, lose the construct Thank you.
more.